to do a back bend, and I'm going to show you a couple of stretches to do. Do not skip this part of the video because it's very important to stretch, because you don't want to break your back. So let's get started. Alright, so I'll show you the first stretch I do. So I don't know how to record this, but like I'll get like my feet together and do like the butterfly pose. You put your two feet together and wait like that, and then you get your head to touch them. It's a really good stretch. And then also this one helps you get your splits, but it is a kind of a stretch. So you lean forward, lean back, lean forward, lean back. And then you can straighten your leg, and even if you want, slide into splits. And this is a good stretch that I always do. I'm gonna have to put it somewhere here. Alright, so it's up, down, down to the middle, down, up, stretch. Oh. Try and get your opposite hand to your opposite foot. So one, two. And this is also a good stretch that I've done. So wait, what was it again? I can't remember the stretch, wait. Oh wait. All the stretching you could do, but first step, you have to know how to do the crab. So you're gonna lie down, crab or bridge, whichever one you call it. All right, I think I might just move up a bit higher. Oops. All right, let's see this. Oh, this will probably. Alright, I'm not sure if you can see it. Alright, but the first step is you want to have someone spot me, and someone was actually spotting me all the time. I learned how to do backbend. So you have a mom, brother, sister, older cousin, older anything. It has to be older than you, because I'm not sure if anyone younger than you could actually hold you. Well, you're going to start by someone spotting you a couple of times, and then you want to make sure that your hands are always up by your ears. And then go back. And there you go. But you're going to have to have someone spot. Well, obviously, I don't have anyone here right now, so I can't like show an example. But yeah, so the second step is first step, you have to know it to do the crab. Second step, you need to have someone spot you. And the third step is to always have your hands up by your ears, and don't be scared. It's really scary when you first try it, and the things that I recommend trying on, like a mat like we have, not sure if you can see, but we have a nice pink mat, and a bed maybe, and the grass. I do not recommend like doing it on the tile floor or like wooden floor or anything hard, because you might hurt yourself, or even a couch if you want, like anything soft. And I'll show you. Alright guys, I just need to go back to 1 second. Alright guys, I'm back. And so like I said, the three first steps, and I'm pretty sure when people have spot you a load of times and stuff, I'm pretty sure you should just go for it. I recommend trying doing it on a bed first, but like, because that's where I first learned how to do it. I was like really happy that did get teached a bit by my coach, so like if you go to gymnastics, you could always ask your coach to, because your coach is definitely like one of the most safest people, because they know all about gymnastics. So now you just go from hands up by your ears, lean back, and there you got it. And so how I went, so I went from bed to grass, grass, and then grass to mat. I haven't tried it on hard floor yet because I'm a bit marina. Yeah, I'm not sure if you heard that, but like, yeah, I kind of am. And me and Erin have the variety of gymnastics practice thing. We have, look, I'll show you. So we have a mat. Oops. And don't mind that car, that's Ethan's. And then we have a beam. And then out the back garden, we have a trampoline, but it's raining and dark, so like we can't use a trampoline. So, yep. And Ethan also has his own mini trampoline. If you could see it, there's that there. And that's pretty much it for this week's video. Bye. Oh yeah, we'll be so posting Saturday or maybe Friday as well.